how to do every challenge, ritual, trial, whatever you want to call it in Revelations. Oh my God, I hope I got every challenge this time around. I know I missed a few last time, but 6, 6, and 6. I feel like I got them all. I've restarted the game like a dozen times, tried to find new challenges, but still the same one. So I think I got all of them here. If I didn't, let me know. We'll work on it there. So yeah, if you're new to these type of videos, you just have to click on the screen. If you have annotations enabled, just click on the challenge and you'll be taken exactly where the challenge is in the video. I'll show you how to do it. And if you're on mobile, the timestamps will be in the description so you can easily navigate throughout the video. Before we get started on the challenges, I'll show you the ritual room and the rewards you get for doing it. So before we get into the ritual challenges or whatever, if you have no idea what I'm talking about, right off spawn, if you head to this far part of the spawn, this is what you should do every match because it's really easy. All you have to do is you put 5 hundo in, and all of a sudden these bad boys will just start clawing at you, and it's just a one-hit knife, so anyone can do that. When the ritual ends, this back portal will open, and you'll be taken to Nocturne Tutin, one of the islands in this map. And this is where you'll find your challenges for the game. So the green one, doing that one will give you a max ammo, the purple one will give you a perk bottle, and the blue one will give you a pack-a-punched weapon. Just like old maps, nothing new here. Now we can get on to the actual challenges. Complete Corruption Engine without getting any kills. Well, if you've played the map and you know how to turn the power on, this is what Corruption Engine is. It's where you spend the 500 points and then all these bastards come at you. So you just gotta train around here and don't get any kills. It's not too hard. Make sure your Widow's Wine doesn't kill anything. But the easiest way to do this is right when the game starts. Just head over to the one in spawn and do it there. Those zombies are very slow. They're not gonna touch you. So pretty easy challenge. Craft the Keeper Protector Altar. So this is just a buildable we need to build with 3 parts located all around the map. Let's talk about the first part. I believe this is the flag part. So the first location is just going to be in the Mob Dead Cafeteria, just right against that wall. Alright, for the second location, if we hurry our tight little buns over to the Origins area, it's going to be in this open area across from the old generator over there. Just be on one of those sandbags on the side of the hill there. And the last location is going to be up on this mound and right there in the corner. So there's the first part. Alright, for the gem part, we're going to head over to the Shangri-La Dryzendrak area. The first piece is going to be located in this bucket right here. If it's not there, don't worry, we'll show you the other 2 spots. The second location is just going to be on the pyramid here, just under this rubble. And lastly, the third location is quite a ways away. It's in the Kino part of the map. Just head to the left outside and you can see it sitting on the table. So there's all the gem parts. Now the third and final part, the skull piece, we're going to head over to Varuk, and the first location is just going to be on this bookshelf right here. The second location is just going to be up these stairs and on this wheelchair right there, and as you can see it was there for me. And finally the last location is just going to be on the way to the little teleporter thinger, and once again on that wheelchair. So there's all 3 parts. Now that you have all 3 parts, just take that bitch to any of the craft stations located all around the map, and it doesn't matter where you build it because you'll be able to access it from any of these spots. And there's your challenge completed. And you also got the Keeper Protector thing, which is pretty nifty. Equip the Dragon Shield. So the Dragon Shield is a buildable. We need to find 3 parts, and let's start with the first part. So the first location is just going to be on the left right there. The second location is just going to be on this box, as you can see. And sorry, I'm running fast. I got a bunch of zombies on my ass. And the last location is on that chair right there. Don't really know what to call the second piece, so we'll just call it the red piece. We're going to head over to Varuk. And the first location is just going to be on this pillar right here. If it's not here, just take a gander upstairs, and it's going to be in this back corner on the wheelchair. As you can see, it was there for me. And if it's not there, you can head over to the kitchen, and I take the extra long, complicated route, but I get there in the end, that's all that matters. And right on the table, the island there, will be the third and final location. After the third and final piece, you can head over to Dryzendrak and make sure the low gravity is off. First location is right up there. These parts are really easy to see. The second location is just going to be on this wall. And the third location is just going to be on this left side of the wall. So there you go. Now that you have all three parts, take it to any crafting table. I like the Nocturne Teuton one. And there you have it. Equip it, and you're good to go. Headshot 10 Apothecan Furies. Apothecan Furies are the new zombie in this map. And they primarily come after you when you're doing the corrupted generators, as you can see right here. But if you don't get enough headshots, they'll start to spawn later on in the rounds, just through regular rounds. And nothing too special here, you just gotta get some headshots. Kill 5 zombies with each type of trap. So there's 3 traps you gotta kill zombies with. The first one is gonna be the corrupted generator. After you turn the power on, it actually turns into a turret here, and it's a pretty cool trap. All you gotta do is kill 5 zombies with this bad boy. After that, we're gonna head over to Varuk, and we're gonna hit them with the electric trap. So just up the staircase there, you have the trap. And just kind of chill there, wait for all the zombies to come over, and make sure you've killed 5 of them. And the final trap's kind of hidden. It's the good old Shinonuma Flogger. It's over in the Origins area by the old generator. And as you can see, 5 zombies, 3 traps. There we go. Not too hard at all. Use beam to kill 15 zombies. So after you do all the corrupted generators and turn the power on, the headstone here actually turns into a trap. $2,000 turns into a turret. And nothing too complicated here. All you gotta do is beam 15 zombies. Kill 5 zombies on each island within the same round. This one's not too hard. I did it around round 8. I think I had 1 zombie to spare, so you might want to wait till after round 8. So I'll show you what I did here. I'm just gonna start from the spawn island, kill 5 zombies. I'm just going to hurry my tight cheeks over to the other island. This is the Dereisendrak, the Kino section. And if you go down to the left side of Kino, there is the next jump pad we can take. But I'm going to kill my 5 zombies on this island, so bada bing, bada boom, 5 zombies. Now we're moving on to the Varuk section, or the Varuk island. So once again, I'm just going to head over to the jump pad, or whatever it's called. Take my sweet time. And wait for 5 more zombies to spawn at me. So there's 5 islands in total you have to do this. This is the third one. And these zombies are just taking their sweet time. But make sure you get 5 kills. You don't want to have to do this again because it's quite a journey. Now we're headed to the Mob of the Dead, or the Origins Island. And I'm once again, the 5th island is Nocturne Teuton. So I'm going to actually have to do one of these corrupted portal generator thing so I can get there. And in the process here, I do kill 5 zombies. I'm careful not to kill too much because I don't want to kill more than I have to, because the round might end since I'm doing this on such an early round. But after I've killed my 5 zombies, I'm going to head to the Nocturne Teuton. And this is the last island. 5 more zombies should pop up anytime here. 3, 4, and the 5th one, there it is, challenge complete. Not too hard at all, a little time consuming, but yeah. Kill 10 spiders with the shield. Not too hard, you have to build the shield first, which is probably the hard part if you don't know how to build it. It was already covered in one of the green challenges, so just head back to the glossary. I think it's the equip the dragon shield. It has all the locations there, I'm not going to do it again. And all you have to do is come to the Pack-a-Punch, the Apothecan guy. And spiders will spawn, but they don't spawn all the time, only on select rounds. So if you're not seeing any spiders, you may just have to wait a few rounds or leave the Apothecan and come back. But they'll pop up eventually, and just kill 10 of them. Kill 10 zombies while they are jumping between islands. So this is kind of a tricky one. You probably want a sniper or something for this, but that's what I used. I found it easy. So anyways, I just went from the spawn room to the Origins area. And if you take a few steps back from the portal, you'll actually see zombies flying up in the air. And you'll only be able to kill a few before other zombies try to mess with you. So you're going to have to do a couple jumps. So wait for the teleporter to open up again. And now I'm back in the spawn. Take a few steps back and look in the sky and just start skeet-shooting the shit out of them. But yeah, you only kill about 3 zombies per travel. So you just got to keep going back and forth between the islands. And there you have it. Kill 15 spiders, so nothing too special about this one. All you have to do is head into into the Apothecan or the Pack-a-Punch room, and spiders will spawn here, but they don't spawn all the time. So if they stop spawning, you may just have to play through a few rounds or leave the Apothecan and come back. I'm not too sure how it works, but they're not going to be here all the time. But eventually they will pop up, and just make sure you pop 15 of them off and you're good to go. Survive 7 rounds in Nocturne Tune. So if you're unfamiliar with this place, this is actually the first Zombies map ever created, and it is one of the islands in this map, and how you get there is you got to turn the power on with the corrupted engine things. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, there's literally one in spawn. You just walk straight ahead, you pay $500, zombies come after you, and a portal will open, and this is where you'll be headed to. So the challenge says survive 7 rounds in Nocturne Tune. On previous maps, it's specified if this is consecutive. It doesn't say it's consecutive, so I don't know if you can peace out whenever you want. But regardless, if you come here right off spawn, right on round 1, which is easy to do, there is Juggernog upstairs you can buy, and there's a few wall weapons. So I think you can do this right off the bat. You should check this room anyways at round 1 to see what your challenges are, but I mean, I'm using Perkaholic here. I didn't try this without Perkaholic, but there is Juggernog upstairs and wall weapons, and I think surviving to round 7 wouldn't be too hard. You really don't want to wait till like round 20 and then have to survive 7 rounds in here, because that would be awful, but early on you got to get this challenge done, and not too bad. Use beam deflections to kill 10 zombies. So there's a new trap in this map, the turret thing, and what you got to do is you got to use it, and you got to pretty much shoot this rock, or shoot any of the rocks on any of these turrets, and the beam will actually deflect and kill zombies. So it's kind of a weird challenge. Normally if you're using this trap like a normal person, you just shoot the zombies, but you need to deflect the beam, and the easiest thing to deflect it off is just the rocks in front right there, and it's not too bad of a challenge once you realize what to do. Kill 3 Marguas inside the Apothecan. This one's not really too bad, but it's kind of a pain in the ass. Pretty self-explanatory. What I like to do is just wait for the Margua to spawn and then head over to the Apothecan, because I don't really like training here at least. So whenever Margua spawns, I would just head over here and kill it. But the way the Margua spawn is kind of random. Like, Marguas don't really spawn often, and they're kind of random, so if Margas aren't spawning, just try training in different parts of the map, because I feel like that has something to do with it. Don't stay in one place. But typically the first Margas will spawn around 12-13, and then about 6 or 7 rounds after was in Shadows of Evil, but in this map it's not really like that. They are just random and they don't really spawn much, so it's going to take you a while to do this ritual or do this challenge. Might not even be worth it, but what I did was just waited for a Margas to spawn, and then I headed to the Apothecan and killed them there. Kill 5 zombies on an island that you are not on. This one's not hard at all, just requires some box luck. There's lots of weapons you can use. I believe I used the gravity cocks for this one. There's also the Apothecan Servant would work. Little Arnie's would work too. And you can see this is done really early. Just train up some zombies, drop your gravity spikes, whatever you're using, and you fly over to the other island, and the other zombies will just keep getting killed by whatever weapon it is. So like I said, there's a few things you can use. Gravity spikes is really easy, but just whatever you get in the box. Kill a Mech Z without taking any damage. So this right here is probably the hardest challenge. I had to do this so many times before I got to work, and I hate to limit it to one strategy, but you pretty much need the Thunder Gun, pack a punch at 2, and around 17-18 the Mech Z will spawn, and you just gotta blast the shit out of him. Like, I tried with so many different weapons and so many different strategies, but eventually the Thunder Gun worked, and you can't, when he spawns, don't go too close to him, because he's got a flamethrower and he'll hit you right off the bat, so you're effed right there. You gotta keep some distance, but you gotta be ready to just blast him away when he spawns, and it's a tough one. Survive for 15 minutes inside the Apothecan. Pretty self-explanatory. You gotta survive for 15 minutes inside the Apothecan, and usually they're round-based, but this one's time-based, so you can head here whenever. You know, you don't have to do this early on, because 15 minutes is 15 minutes whether you're on round 1 or round 100. So one thing to note is it doesn't say consecutively, so that could be 15 minutes total of your whole game inside the Apothecan. So if you do go down like I did, I have no perks, as you can see. You might be able to leave the Apothecan, get your shit, and go back and finish the rest of those 15 minutes. So, not too bad, but yeah. three-shot Killamargua. This one's actually kind of tricky. This challenge was definitely made for the Thunder Gun, so you're definitely going to want that. And the tricky part about this challenge is you can't do any damage to the Margua except for three shots. So if you got Widow's Wine or Electric Cherry and you hit the Margua, that counts as a shot and you're not going to end up getting the three-shot challenge. So what you need to do is you need to take your time with this Margua, and you also have to make sure that his head is open when you shoot him with the Thunder Gun. If you try to shoot him and his heads aren't open, which means he can't take any damage, that you're going to fail the challenge. So as you can see, I'm on round 33. I've killed a few Margos in this game, and it took me this long to get it. So as you can see, there's two heads. There's the third one open up, and I have three shots total with the Thunder Gun. That's all it takes. Kill each of the elemental Margos. So the Margos are back in this map, but they're different colors, and they do different abilities. So I think there's only about three, maybe even two. I felt like I only killed two to do this challenge, but what you got to do is Margo will spawn, and hopefully it's a different color, and I'm not too sure how the spawning works, but I think it might be related to where you are on the map as well. So if you're not getting a certain type of elemental Margo, you might just want to switch areas. So yeah, there might be two Margos you have to kill, three tops. There's definitely not four Margos, but they're very easy to see, different colors, and just hopefully you get the challenge when you kill Margos. So not too hard, just kind of got to play through the game a little bit.